Entopia. WCAG 2.2 at a glance. 2.5.7, dragging movements. Point, click, drag, and drop. If you've used a pointer, you've probably had to do these actions. A pointer could be a mouse, a stylus, or even your finger. And for some people, dragging a pointer can be quite a drag. A dragging movement requires strength to hold down the pointer and dexterity to move it into place. These actions can be difficult for some people. As well as this, some assistive technology does not work well with dragging, such as voice control or eye gaze systems. Success criterion 2.5.7 dragging movements is about making sure that any function achieved through a dragging movement has a pointer-based alternative that only requires one point of contact with the screen, like a single tap. So, what is considered a dragging movement? Let's say we want to move a file from one folder to another with a mouse. First, we click and hold down the left mouse button to pick up the file. Then we drag the file across the screen. And finally, we release the mouse button once the file reaches its destination. While moving the file, we can travel on any path we want. Only the start and end points matter. This is what separates dragging movements from path-based gestures, which are covered under Success Criterion 2.5.1, Pointer Gestures. If you have interactions that rely on a dragging motion, there must be a pointer-based alternative with just one point of contact. This includes single taps and clicks, double taps and clicks, and long presses. Some examples might be using a drop-down menu or text input to provide a precise value instead of a slider. Sorting items by tapping the item to engage it, then tapping where to move it to, instead of holding for drag and drop. Or moving around a map using arrow buttons instead of dragging. These interactions are all capable of being completed with just one point of contact. It's worth mentioning that this criterion is only to do with pointers. You'll still need a keyboard alternative. Often, the accessible alternatives for pointer and keyboard may be the same. For example, if a color picker slider requires dragging, a text field to input a color code, such as hex or RGB, can satisfy both our pointer and keyboard requirements. There are some exceptions to this criterion. When the dragging movement is essential, like in a game, or when the dragging movement is set by the user agent, such as the browser, and has not been changed, your alternative can be a separate component as long as the functionality is equivalent. So let's keep the web from being a drag.